Hey guys and welcome to RussZone.com. This is Mohit Soni. What we're driving today is the Tiago EV. It's been a long while that we finally got our hands on the Tiago EV because we had seen it at launch. We told you every single detail about it in terms of features, how it looks like, what are the changes, what has been done to make this car a really good car. Unfortunately, really long time to test drive it, but we have spent quality amount of time. We've charged it multiple times. We have done a road test with this and I'm happy to report a lot of things. So I'm just linking the videos above for the walk around where I tell you everything in detail. I am going to stick to my experiences with the car while driving because the rest of it is covered very extensively. Let's kick into the driving part directly then. This is a motor which makes 74 PS of power and 110 Newton meters of torque. This is very close to the numbers that are seen on the petrol and CNG Tiago as well. And this Tiago also is quite an impressive one. I've been impressed with the petrol, with the diesel, with the CNG, with the twin cylinder, with the AMT CNG, and now with the EV as well. This shows the fact that Tata's commitment in the passenger vehicle segment is through the roof. They're offering everything with every car, every powertrain option possible is being done on the Tiago as well, which has now become a very solid benchmark in how to do an entry level hatchback. You can do it all, you can give it all, and the customers will really appreciate it. It's all about choice now, and with the EV you get this instant power and torque. Of course it isn't or chattering or anything like that, but you still get instant power, instant torque from the word go, and you've got sport mode as well. You've got three regen modes on offer, which I have a dedicated buttons right here to make things better and easier for you. You've got charging port open button here, and you've got a lock unlock button, and you can open the boot. So dedicated buttons in a time like this today are very hard to find, but you can see that in the Tiago, and you will, because of course it is a budget car. So in terms of driving, like I told you, the performance is good enough, and most importantly the range test has shown us the fact that you can only get around 200 kilometers with this car if you're really careful, maybe 220. But at times, one time we even got 160 while driving heavy footed most of the time. So this is something gives you a way, varied perspective on how you drive this car, and that's how the range will be showcased to you. That is something is a good number, only because the fact that you're going to drive this in the city, you're not going to venture into highway driving and go to another city. You are going to do, like our cities are also getting bigger, and what happens is that you do drive from one part of the city to the other. At times that can be 30, 40 kilometers as well, maybe even 50 or 60. So going and coming back, getting around 200 kilometers of range should be sufficient enough. But for the reasons that I have seen customers buy the Tiago is that they are looking for something to drive within the city. They charge it once a week, and that is what makes the Tiago EV a very, very good car for them to live with on a daily basis. With enough range and the charging, which is around the 6 to 8 hour mark, you can charge it overnight and enjoy this convenience of an EV car, and that is not bad at all. What is also really impressive is the steering and the way it drives. Ride quality is on the softer side. It's not really a very excellent handler like the petrol, CNG or diesel that used to be. This is slightly on the softer side, and despite that, highway stability is good. It goes around corners quite well with minimum body roll, and the steering is the big highlight. It is actually a really good steering. It's got faster returns, it's light and precise, it gets heavier as well. So there is so much on offer here. While driving this car, it is so easy to live with that you will just fall in love with this car driving all again and again. So that is something that has impressed us quite a bit with the Tiago EV. Let me just show you how easy it is to take a U-turn in this. That's it. So small, easy, affordable and fun to drive cars are always something that most of us enjoy. The Tiago is exactly that with every powertrain, with the EV, with the instant torque. It just makes so much light work of driving within the city, it is quite brilliant. The brakes, well, coupled with regen, no brakes are really that great. In fact, there was a time when I waited for the regen to stop the vehicle, but at the same time something came in between. I had to push the brakes, but I couldn't get on the brakes, so I had to do an evasive maneuver to get out of that sticky situation. So you either keep the regen on one, or you keep on regen and three, and keep a lot of patience as well within you, because there will be a moment where you're waiting for the regen to slow down the car, but if something comes in between, you have to hit the brakes. You will realize that you know, you need a bit more powerful brakes. Apart from that, I think I've told you that it drives really well on the highway, in the city. It's very easy to live with, feels stable as well. This is something that you know, really impresses with the kind of small footprint it has on the road. And despite that, it's you know, like a proper Tata hatchback, which feels very safe. It is 4-star rated. You've got a decent touchscreen here with wired Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. You've got TPMS, you've got leather seats. All of that is being put to good use quite well. Of course, you can't expect power and ventilated seats here, but you are getting, and you know, driving modes as well as regen modes, and that makes the Tiago EV quite a premium car to live with on a daily basis. You've got the convenience of keyless entry and go, push button and start, and that's something you can only find in the Tiago EV, and on the very top end, features that you can find in the petrol and CNG and other powertrain options. So really impressed with the Tiago EV and what it offers and what it has become. It's become a phenomenal name, and it had to, because it had the legacy of Indica to live with, and it has delivered on that aspect quite well. That's what the Tiago EV is all about. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you like, share and subscribe. Follow us on our channel and website for everyday updates. Until then, goodbye.